We thought of life through analogy of a journey, a pilgrimage, with something serious at the end. And the thing at the end, be it success at the end or maybe heaven after we're dead, but we missed the point the whole way along. It was a musical thing, and you were supposed to sing and dance while the music was being played. Now, Alan Watts is this British guy who brought Buddhist thinking to North America. He has a whole bunch of lectures you can watch online that are from like the 70s, and he's a super awesome guy. And he's actually like the counterbalance to the other thinkers that I follow who are more like execution oriented, very mission oriented, and they take life very, very seriously. But here's the thing, maybe you turn on the Discovery Channel, you know, just a little too late, you know, you turn on like some 10 p.m. Ancient Aliens or whatever, and you very quickly realize that like weekly we're almost hit by solar flares that wipe out much of civilized society, or the odd news headline, or an asteroid narrowly comes by. And if that were to actually happen, like, would you have been here taking things super seriously, or would you have just been here having fun? What I want to talk to you about today is extending Alan Watts's analogy of singing and dancing in life, what you can do when planning out a gap year of your own, because you'll be tempted to take it very seriously. After all, you've been in school for fucking 12 years where everything is very structured and very serious, and you better get the grade, otherwise you're not going to go to this school or that school. So why not let go of that and actually like have fun for a change? So I'm going to give you 3 things that you can walk away with today that are going to help better shape your understanding of how to spend this year to yourself. So without further ado, let's talk gap year. So the first thing to understand is momentum. Now, maybe you've been in like a nightclub setting before, or maybe just like a high school house party, inevitably you're gonna bump into like a wall of guys sitting there with their drinks doing absolutely nothing, thinking about everything that they could be doing in their head. I mean, literally everyone's been guilty of it. When you're sitting there, there is an inertia to overcome, to actually get yourself off the wall and start doing things that make you uncomfortable and actually relax and talk to people, sing a little, dance a little, you know what I mean? Now, when talking about gap years and all the things that you could be doing, it'll be very super duper tempting to spend like the first 2 months just with like a notebook and a pen, scribbling down all the things you could be doing and all the things you'd like to be doing, how you're gonna spend this wonderful year to yourself. You know, you're no different than that dude who's just sitting there on the wall thinking about all the people he could be talking to. I encourage you to take a shift. Shifting away, well, yes, planning is necessary. You don't want to put yourself in a situation where you're in danger. Of course not. I'd never recommend anyone do that. But actually, instead of like writing down, I'm gonna get fit, why not just shut up and do that right now? Instead of writing down like, I might get good grades, or I might save some money, and I hope that maybe I can go to Thailand. Why not just take actionable steps today, right now? They're gonna get you closer to that. Because what you're gonna find is it pulls you out of your head and it puts you in the world. And all of a sudden your eyes light up a little more. Now you're in the middle of the dance floor and everybody's looking at you because you're just so vibrant, so full of life, that people just wanna be around that sort of energy. Now, the second thing to think about is finding a good dance partner. Sounds kind of silly, but just hear me out, okay? What exactly is dancing, to be totally honest? What it is just a form of self-expression with your body. And what makes someone good at it is just having tools to be able to communicate how they feel more accurately. So many people go from high school to a very just crappy job. You know, Tim Hortons, KFC, your McDonald's. And while, yes, it's important to pay bills, it's a necessary part of life. It's like choosing a dance partner that's teaching you lockstep. It's very rigid, and it teaches you how to act in a very particular way while following orders. It doesn't really encourage you to let go a little bit and express yourself creatively and honestly to who you actually are. So one thing I recommend this to literally everybody, mostly because it's something I did out of high school, and that is to pick up some kind of a trade, something that when you do it, the better you get at it, the more money you will be paid. And not only that, it feels like more honest work because it actually requires you to use your brain. Now, with that said, when we talk about trades work, the default is construction. I gotta be a construction worker. And while, yes, that's something you do with your hands and you will get paid more as you get better at it, there's a lot of other trades. You know, you could get really good at cooking, you know, be a line cook, hairdressing, like anything in the beauty industry. Maybe you're big into makeup and stuff. Even just creative work. You can become a graphic designer with no education whatsoever. I mean, you do need to actually possess some talent to work on, but that's something you can learn today versus waiting for a school to tell you you're ready to do that. Pick a good dance partner. Pick a job that as you get better at it, it's gonna give you more tools to act in the world to make the change that you want to make, while also encouraging you to open up your mind a little bit more and express yourself honestly. And the third thing comes from a favorite author of mine. His name is Gabor Mate. In an interview giving advice to his younger self, one of the things he said was that he'd wish he would just slow down and let life come to him. This sounds like it sounds like I'm contradicting myself from momentum, but hear me out. In music, you know, maybe you're into that EDM stuff. I just discovered it. I'm kind of ashamed of myself for enjoying it, but I just found it. And the reality is the bass drop is going to come. Something exciting is always coming with music like that. And to say life is any different, it would just be ignoring the facts. So while, yeah, it's important to make things happen, you have to go out and achieve the results you want to achieve. It's weird to notice things just fall into your lap without any work. So while, yes, pull on your boots and get out there and make things happen, build momentum, it's also important to understand that not everything has to be remarkably difficult. And the things that you probably want right now, you're already worthy of getting. So you don't have to like put up these walls that you have to break through, if that makes sense. So if you're panicking, trying to figure out what to do on your gap year, then I'd imagine a very fun analogy isn't all too helpful for you. So what will be helpful for you is this video I made over here, where I lay out four things that most people don't really get to until like their later 20s or even like their 30s or not at all. So if you work on one of these four things during your gap year, you can't go wrong. You're gonna get so much out of it. So check out this video if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.